Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about application and network architecture in Oracle Database. So first thing, to take the full advantage of the given computer system or the network, Oracle Database enables processing to split between the database server and the client program. So here, whatever the activity you are doing, like you just want to access the data from the database. So here Oracle Database has divided these things into two things. One is a database server and one is a client programs. Fine. So client is going to be connected to your Oracle Database, and whatever the information is required, that database server gives to the client. Okay, the computer running the RDBMS handles the database server responsibility, while the computer running on the application handle the interpretation and displaying the data. So here basically two things, database and the application. So here database server responsibility, while the computer running on the application handle the interpretation and displaying the data. So this is going to be displaying your only data, okay, and what is doing, it is managing the server responsibility. Fine. Whatever the data is required, that is taken from the database and given to the application. Application will just display your data. Okay, so first is your application architecture. So the application architecture refers to the computing environment in which database application connects to the Oracle database. Fine. The two most common database architecture are client server architecture and multi-tier architecture. So here, in the client server architecture, the client application initiate the request for operation to be performed on the database server. So here what actually happened, client send the request to the server, server process the request and send it back to your client. So this is the first thing, that is your client server architecture. Next, the server receives and process the request that originate from the client. Okay. In the traditional multi-tier architecture, one or more application servers performs the part of an operation. So here you have a one or more application servers which is sending request to your database. The application server contains a large part of application logic, provide access to the data for the client and perform the some query processing, thus lessening the load on your database. Fine. So if you have multiple application on that time, what happened? Multiple queries are executing on your database. So some loads are there on your database server. If you have a multiple application, means you have a one to many or many to one relationship. Okay. In the networking architecture, second one, that is Oracle Net Service is the interface between the database and the network communication protocol that facilitate distribution of processing and distributing the database. Means how the users are connecting to your Oracle database. So that is comes under the network architecture. So Oracle Net Service supports the communication on all major network protocols including TCP, IP, HTTP, FTP and the web dev. Fine. So here Oracle Net is a component of Oracle Network Service, establishes and maintains the network session from client application to database server. So Oracle Net is a one component which handles all these things. So whenever you are installing the Oracle database software, okay, on that time Oracle Net component is already also installed. Fine. After the network session is established, means everything is fine, network is between there, between client to server, Oracle Net act as a data courier for both client application and the database servers. Fine. After that, how it is works? Once the network is established, whatever the client is requesting, fine, which is sending that data, this is my request, there are some packets it is sending over the network to the server. Server collect those data and give it back to the clients over the network. So it is work as a one kind of data courier. Fine, exchanging the message between them. Okay, Oracle Net can perform this job because it's located on each computer in the network. Fine. So this is how can it done? Because it is located on each computer. An important component of Oracle Net service is the listener. Fine. Which is a separate process that runs on database server as well in the network. So on the database server, what you have? You have a listener. Fine. Once you have a listener, that means it will listen to your client request. This is the one important component. Means clients are there, server is there, but how the client is going to be communicate to the, your server. So using the listener. So on the server side, you should first configure the your listener. Okay. Client application can send a connection request to the listener, which manage the traffic of this request to the your database server. When the connection is established, the client and the database communicate directly. Means you have a listener. Client send the request. Fine. Connect. First of all, it will check. Listener is there? Yes. It will do the connection with your database. Once the connection is done, after that, client and the database communicate directly. After that, the listener is not required. Listener is just initially you required for the connection purpose. Okay, the most common way to configure the Oracle database to the service client request are the two things, dedicated server architecture and the shared server architecture. So here the each client process connect to the dedicated server process. So each and every clients connect to the your server in the dedicated server process, means each one client, fine, listener is one, but process is also separate. Here the server process is not shared by any other client for the duration of the client session. Fine. So whenever the client sending the request, on that time on the server end, on the database server, you have one server process which performing all this activity, means whatever the client is sending the request, like select star from employee. So what happened? First of all, listener will listen the request. Fine. Server process is established and it will perform the all the activity. But in the dedicated architecture, this server process is not shared to the any other client process or any other processes in the database. This is dedicatedly for the client process. Okay. Each new session assigns the dedicated server process. Means if you have 10 clients, 10 server process will be allocated on the your database server. If you have 1000 connections, so 1000 server process is going to be allocated on your Oracle database server. But whenever you are comparing this thing with the shared server architecture, the database use the pool of shared processes for the multiple session. Here, one-to-one relationship is not there. One client process, one server process. That relationship is not here in the shared server. That's why the name is given shared server and this is given the dedicated server architecture. The client process communicate with the dispatcher, fine, which is a process that enables many clients to connect to the same database instance without need for the dedicated server process for each client. So here dispatcher is there which accept the request from the client end and this will perform the all the activity. It is sending the request to the your database server. So here the need for the dedicated server process for each client, it is not required. Fine, like 1000 users are there. That doesn't mean in the shared server architecture you have 1000 server processes. Fine. So here this is the differences between the dedicated server architecture and the shared server architecture. So in this session we have discussed about the application and the network architecture. Thank you.